A lot of our whales from the 19th century came from whaling stations. They remove the flesh, they remove the blubber, they render it down to oil, and then they just sort of cast these things out. Our curators could, you know, pick through this stuff and look for good specimens. And, you know, a problem with it is that they tend to get jumbled together. So you try to make sure that you're getting a specimen that has some integrity, that you know that it's all from one animal. But they did collect specimens where they knew it was not all from one animal. For instance, you know, the sweet spot for harpooning would be right sort of here between the shoulder blades, right here behind the head. And so they often hit the scapula and broke it. And so if they wanted a good scapula, they might take it from a nearby specimen, and which they did. For instance, the gray whale that we have in our osteo hall right now.
So we're in the adjacent building next to where the large cetaceans were. This is where slightly smaller cetaceans are housed, and entirely these collections belong to living species.
Over the years, we brought in a huge number of specimens from the stranding network on the east coast of the United States and elsewhere throughout the world. And there's a whole network of marine labs that will collect these specimens, and then they get put in their freezers, and I go out and pick them up and bring them here, and they've accumulated, and I've prepared them as osteological specimens. But the data is very important, where and when, and who collected them, and what measurements were taken off of them, and what tissues were collected from them. And we make a catalog record and assign it a catalog number. Then it gets put in one of these cases here where it belongs. One of our research associates was Bill Perrin. And as a graduate student at UCLA, he went out with the tuna fleet and to study dolphins, and he came to realize what a huge problem it was, that how many dolphins were being killed in the tuna nets. And they did collect a lot of these dead animals. And while it's a very sad legacy, on the other hand, it is an invaluable resource for science that we otherwise would not have had.